10 fragrances with the best dry down. There's no denying the fact that the dry down of the fragrance is the most important part. The opening is not going to last that long. 10, maybe 15 minutes for most fragrances out there is when you're going to be experiencing the opening notes. After that, that's when it starts to transition into the mid and dry down. And depending on how long the fragrance lasts, that dry down can last from, you know, 4 or 5 hours to an upwards of 10, 11, 12 hours, or even more than that. So this is why I preach all the time in my videos. Guys, when you're testing fragrances, one, you have to spray it on your skin so it develops. And two, to go along with that, you need it to develop so that way you can get into the dry down properly and then really decide if you like the fragrance or not. Because judging a fragrance off the opening notes, it's only going to be there 10, 15 minutes. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense when the majority of the time you're going to be enjoying the fragrance is in the dry down hours and hours later. So it is important that you make sure you test your fragrances to the fullest extent, and it's important to make sure that you enjoy the dry downs of your fragrances, especially winter fragrances, because winter fragrances, warm, sweet fragrances are generally all about the dry down. So today I thought I'd go over 10 of the best smelling dry downs in my fragrance collection. But before we get started, I want to hear from you first. Let me know down in the comments which fragrances have the best dry down in your collection. That's one of my favorite parts about doing these videos is getting your feedback, hearing your lists, and hearing your ideas, because that kind of helps me to cater my videos towards you and might give me some ideas to pick some new stuff up. And the second thing is, if you're new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Also, turn on post notifications and give this video a like. All that helps out the channel, helps us to continue to grow, helps me to continue to produce more content for you guys, so I really do appreciate it. And now, with that out of the way, let's go and jump right into this video, starting off with the first fragrance we have, Pure Excess Night. So this is the brand spanking new shiny release, Pure Excess Night. This one's really nice. I've talked about this one a number of times so far on my channel. Major improvement over the original Pure Excess. If you weren't fully happy with the original, you thought like maybe it was something missing, you thought it was just a little bit boring, highly recommend you check out Pure Excess Night. This one is a huge improvement over the original. A little bit more unique, it's longer lasting, the quality in my opinion is better. It's just really, really nice flanker, a really nice follow-up to the original Pure Excess, which I did think smelled pretty nice. It just really didn't have enough going for me, so I ended up selling off my bottle. But I really do like Pure Excess Night, and there's going to be a link down below in the description where you can pick this one up at an insane price, along with all the other fragrances on this list. It's pretty much going to be the lowest prices possible, so make sure you check that out. Pure Excess Night, this is a great one, and the dry down of this one smells amazing. Nice, warm, and sweet. It's just a really nice one. Up next, we have Azzaro Pour Homme Intense. So I love this fragrance. This one is really nice, really well done. This one is warm, sweet. It's got a nice cinnamon note in the dry down. It smells amazing. And to me, really kind of smells like Christmas. It really kind of smells like the holidays. Probably a lot to do with that cinnamon note and just with the other warm, sweet notes. There's just a little bit of a boozy, alcoholic type of smell in this as well. I just think it really fits in to the time of the year of Christmas and just winter like we are now. It's just got this cozy, warming effect about it. Again, you do get all that in the dry down. That's where this one shines. And don't get me wrong, the opening of this one, it smells great too. It is spicy, like I mentioned, but the dry down, that's really where this one shines. Azzaro Pour Homme Intense. This one's quite a bit different than the original Azzaro Pour Homme, and this is the newer Intense version, which has a completely different note breakdown and structure and all that stuff, just so you don't get it confused with the other Azzaro Pour Homme Intense, which has a similar structure and note breakdown to the original Azzaro Pour Homme. So it's kind of confusing. There's been a few different Azzaro Pour Homme Intense versions, but this one is the most recent one, the one that you can get your hands on basically everywhere. This one's really nice. If you want kind of a play on that classic type of scent for men, but just with a little bit more of a warm, spicy touch, definitely check this one out. This one's fantastic. Really solid and really affordable too. Azzaro Pour Homme Intense, great dry down on this one. This one is killer. Moving up next, we have Carner Barcelona Elborn. So you already know my love for this fragrance. This one's amazing. This is a vanilla scent. It's got vanilla, honey, Peru balsam, a few other sweet notes as well. This is a sweet fragrance. There's no getting around that. It's not a masculine fragrance. It's not a leather, strong fragrance like that. This one's sweet. This one's warm. This one's inviting. And it's unisex. I mean, anyone can wear this one. Anyone can pull it off. Really, if you like vanilla and you just like sweet fragrances, this is one to check out. And the dry down especially is incredible. The vanilla kind of comes across just a little bit boozy, a little bit alcohol-ish as well, which is really nice. One thing about the opening of this fragrance is it can put people off a little bit. The opening is pretty strong and very sweet, so don't let that get to you too much. Let this one hit the dry down, because trust me, once it does, it's going to smell fantastic, and I much prefer the dry down of this one compared to the opening. It's just incredible. It's really mind-blowing to me. It's one of my personal favorite scents. Love it first sniff for me. That is Carner Barcelona Elborn. Really nice stuff here, especially for winter. Hey, real quick, do you want access to some bonus videos and some behind the scenes stuff? If you click that join button next to the subscribe button on my channel, you can look at our channel membership tiers. We have three different tiers. The first one, for $1.99, gets you access to bonus reviews, basically videos that don't make it here on the channel, fragrance reviews and lists. On top of that, you also get access to any sort of other bonus content like vlogs or stuff unrelated to fragrance. Really, it's going to be guided by you guys, the members. Whatever other types of content you want to see, you can suggest it and I can make it happen. So make sure you check it out, channel memberships. Click that join button. That helps to support the channel so I can keep producing more content for you guys. Moving up next, we have probably the cheapest fragrance on this list. This one is CK1 Shock. So this one comes in, I believe you can get the 6.7 ounce bottle, the 200 ml largest size bottle, for around like 24 bucks or something like that. Again, it's gonna be linked down below to FragranceNet where you can pick it up there. Probably gonna be about as cheap as you're gonna get it. This one is incredible. It's got tobacco, it's got amber, it's got some other spicy notes. This smells great. And again, cheapest fragrance on this list, but it's amazing. I really don't think that there is really anything that you can hate on this fragrance about, just because, you know, it is a Calvin Klein, it is cheap, but it's unique. It's not like all the other Calvin Klein summer fragrances, which basically all smell the same in one way or another. This one's got something else going on about it. And again, it's got better performance than all of the other ones as well. This is one of those fragrances where if you don't have this one, I recommend next time you're buying fragrances online, on FragranceNet or whatever, and you don't have this one, just go ahead and throw this one in your cart. It's going to set you back an extra 20 bucks. Maybe it'll get you to that free shipping threshold or something like that. Regardless, I just think this is one you should just throw in at some point and have it in your collection, because you're probably going to be impressed by the quality and smell of this fragrance. And again, the fact that you can get a 200 ml bottle for around 20 bucks, this is a steal of a price. And the dry down smells incredible. Sweet, warm, a little bit spicy. It's a masculine fragrance all the way through. And it's got solid performance to top it all off, which is something that you don't normally get from Calvin Klein. You know, when you get bottles that look like this, all the summer ones, you're gonna have that on your skin for a couple hours and it's gonna be gone. But this one, really strong, or I mean not really strong, but it's a lot stronger than the other ones, and it smells fantastic too. CK1 Shock, if you haven't tried this one yet, highly recommend you do. Up next, we have Acqua di Gio Absolute Instinct. So I love this scent. A huge improvement over the original Acqua di Gio Absolute, which, to be honest with you, I really didn't like all that much. It smelled nice, don't get me wrong, but kind of had this Invictus Aqua sort of smell to it. It's like a more fruity Invictus Aqua, and to be honest, I don't need that. I've got the 2016, I've got the 2018, I've got, you know, the Parfums Vintage Aqua Intense, which is very similar, so I don't need any more Invictus Aqua, and you know, I just didn't like that scent that much. This one, on the other hand, Absolute Instinct, I love. I think this one smells fantastic. They did a really nice job here with this fragrance, and it smells completely different than Absolute Instinct, and to be honest with you, it smells completely different than all of the other fragrances in this line. So this one is more of like a dark aquatic fragrance, if that sort of makes sense. It's kind of hard to describe exactly. Doesn't really smell like Profumo. It doesn't have the incense, patchouli smokiness going on. It just smells more like, you know, a dark aquatic fragrance. It's the best way I can describe it. It smells, got more of like the seaweed type of note, which gives it more of a green undertone. This one's just different, but it's honestly really nice. So if you haven't checked out Absolute Instinct, highly recommend you do. This one is really, really nice. Pretty impressed with this one. And the dry down 100% is where it's at. The opening is pretty good, but the dry down is killer. Up next, we have one of the best date fragrances of all time, or at least that's kind of what it's been called. This one is Yves Saint Laurent La Nuit de L'Homme. So, you know, I love this one. Still being included in my videos for a good reason. It's just a classic that works great. The dry down of this one is where it's at. Although I do love the opening, I love that nice cardamom spicy blast. The dry down with that lavender, with the cardamom, with some of the other sweeter notes is really just the best part. That's like the sweet spot for this fragrance, is the mid and dry down. It smells amazing. It smells alluring. It smells intoxicating. This scent is just a masterpiece. It's very well done. Still a best seller. Still gets talked about all the time just because it's a great scent that works. Really, really killer dry down here. This is one that most of you probably have at this point, but if you don't, I recommend you pick one up because it is incredible. Up next, we have Armani Code Absolue. So this is the new Armani Code Flanker, which I've been talking about a lot, which I've been wearing a lot. This one's incredible. The dry down is insanely good. It's got nice vanilla, tonka bean sweetness. This one lasts a very long time on skin and even on clothing. This is one where I sprayed it on the other day, and then, you know, some of it kind of got on my shirt when I was spraying it on. The next day, I picked up that shirt, and I caught a whiff of something. I'm like, what is that? And, you know, there's a fragrance, and I haven't sprayed on a fragrance yet. And it was the Armani Code Absolute coming off that shirt from the day before. So almost a whole 24 hours later, this was still projecting off of that shirt. Just crazy, crazy strong stuff. Very alluring, very sweet, very sensual. Vanilla, tonka bean, masterpiece right here. Really incredible one. This is another one that is a new release, but it has hit discounters. FragranceNet, at the time of me recording this, has this one for a killer price. It was at around like $67 for this bottle size, which is crazy, crazy cheap. Even cheaper than Armani Code Profumo, I want to say, or it's around the same price. So we'll have that link down below. Check it out. Get it at that price while you can. Even if it's a little bit more expensive than that, still a great deal because I paid like $86 for mine. So if you can get it for a cheap price like that, definitely do so. Up next, we have Tom Ford Noir Extreme. So this is a nice gourmand type fragrance for fall and winter time. And, you know, it's one of those scents that just smells classy. It just smells high end because it's Tom Ford, and those Tom Ford fragrances just have a way of doing that. This one is really, really nice. It's sweet, it's warm, it's inviting. The opening, it smells great. And just like with basically all the other fragrances in this list, the openings do smell good. However, the dry down is where it's at with this one and with all the other ones as well. So this is one where if you're trying it, if you go to a department store and you spray it on and you test the opening, make sure you wait until the dry down to get the full effect, because this one really opens up, develops, and smells amazing in the dry down. Up next, we have John Varvatos Nick Jonas Crimson. So this is another one of my new found loves. This has been one of my favorites lately. I love the scent. It's fruity with a little bit of a sweet undertone as well. You get that apple up top, you get some coffee, some other sweet notes in the dry down. This one smells incredible. Really, really happy with this one. And again, this is one where you can pick up at a pretty good price despite it being new. Again, that link is gonna be down below. Highly recommend you check this one out. If you are a fan of John Varvatos fragrances, you gotta get this one in your collection because it's killer. And even if you haven't tried any John Varvatos fragrances, I don't think you can go wrong with this one. I have yet to smell one that I haven't liked, and I don't know if I ever will. I really hope they keep it up what they're doing here with these new, unique releases. This one's definitely one of them. Smells great, and I get pretty good performance out of it too, which typically is one of the trade-offs that you get from John Varvatos fragrances, but not this one. This one's great performance, great quality, smells amazing. John Varvatos, Nick Jonas, Crimson. Finally, the last fragrance on this list, we have Yves Saint Laurent Rive Gauche Pour Homme. So this one, I'll be honest, the opening, not really a fan of it. I mean, I like it, I don't mind it, but there was something about the first time I smelled this fragrance in the opening, I was like, ooh, what did I get myself into? Wasn't a huge fan of it. Wasn't until I hit the dry down when this one just completely came to life. It got creamy, it got slightly sweet, but still maintained that fresh barbershop type of smell. It literally smelled like shaving cream, and in a good way. It didn't, you know, I mean, it smelled like shaving cream with a fragrance combined, if that makes sense. It's hard to explain. If you haven't tried this one, you need to get your hands on it. Somehow it is discontinued. If I can find it online, I'll link it down below, but no guarantees. Great, great barbershop scent. The dry down is killer. Again, it's creamy, it's soapy, it's slightly fresh. It's just a barbershop scent. It's a fougere fragrance, and it smells incredible. Really, really nice one here with great performance as well. Yves Saint Laurent Rive Gauche Pour Homme. So guys, that's gonna do it for me. That are my 10 fragrances with the best dry down in my collection. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Again, let me know down in the comments which fragrances in your collection have the best dry down. I love hearing from you. That's gonna do it for me, guys. So as always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you tomorrow night with another video. Take care.